This bottle represents sexual crimes. So, whom of you has ever discovered something that shook your world, that you thought, this could not be happening, this cannot be true? I cannot see your hands very well, it's a bit dark, so can you like wave? Yes, thank you. So when I started my research into sexual exploitation of children, I'm deliberately talking about children here. Anyone under 18 is considered a child in the eyes of the law, and it's important for you to really realize this, to feel it. We're talking about children here and not about teenagers. It kind of assumes that it's okay, and I don't think it's okay. So, sexual crimes against children. The best way to explain this is a story my father told me about flat world people. So if we were to take away the dimension of height and we would only have width and length, then the people in the flat world, just imagine for now that's you, would have this. And you would see a circle. And we'd walk around it and we'd say, ah, the truth is, this is actually a circle placed in front of us. But if we were to tip it, we would say, no, it's a rectangle. And we'd be absolutely convinced that we were speaking the truth about this. But none of us would actually be correct. And this is what I found about sexual crimes against children in the Netherlands. There seems to be this huge euphemism happening, whether a child is being abused inside the sex industry or outside of it. So, if a child has been raped outside of the sex industry, the district attorney will start asking for a punishment from 3 years and above. But a trafficker who's exploited a girl for like a month will go to jail for about 8 months, a year, typically. I hardly ever see sentences higher than that. And then what happens if you were to buy that sex from a child? What would your punishment be? Can any of you have any idea? What would you guess, if you had to guess, how high would the sentence be for you to buy sex from a child in the Netherlands? What would the judge give you? Speak up, please. A couple of weeks. A community service. Just a warning. It's actually 1 day. So, today I want to take you down my train of thought. I don't know how many of you know, but the Netherlands, our democracy was founded by the ideas of Spinoza. Baruch Spinoza was a Jewish scholar. He was on the road to a great religious scholar future, but then he decided to have some really out-of-the-box free-thinking ways. He was excommunicated, and he paid the price for his free-thinking ways by not being able to be a part of the Jewish community anymore. And he said something really important. He said, only in a democratic society with reasoning citizens, we will no longer be enemies. The goal of the state is freedom. I love this. To me, the idea of a free state and freedom of citizens is, of course, wonderful. It's one of the things we as Dutch are really proud of. Having the right to choose, having the right for an education, having a right to be provided for. I do wonder if Spinoza realized that the price for freedom can be really high. And I want you to think about, is the price for the actions you are taking, could they cost someone else their freedom? And is that worth it? In 2014, this case, the district attorney told me they really put their hopes in. They thought, we have a case here, it's so solid, there's no judge who's going to be able to just give 1 day sentence now because this crime is totally awful. They were ready for it, they were just gunning for it. They had a case in which a 16-year-old had been exploited for just a month. She had had over 80 customers. The police caught the man having sex with her, red-handed. They had the pimp in the hotel toilet. He had the customer list on his phone. They had the used condoms of over 40 men. that girl had been in that hotel room for just 2 days. She had had over 40 customers. They were quite convinced the judges are just going to go for it. This time we're going to get more than just that one day in jail. Well, they didn't. Two of the men who were taken to trial by the Justice Department, they committed suicide. They changed the eyes and the perception of the justice on this case. They felt really bad for the man who had bought sex from this teenager. So, here comes the court case day, and a district attorney said they asked for about 1.5 years of jail time for these men. They said, the other side of sexual exploitation is the buyers who sustain this sort of human trafficking. These court cases should set a prevention precedent. One less sex buyer means that a child is being abused one less time. Well, no surprise, the judge didn't go for it. And in the defendant's statements, they were all talking about how big the impact was on their life. And the district attorney said it, and I'm going to say it again. To me, it is awful that we value our freedom above the freedom of someone else. And I think it's about time we talk about this more. As an NGO working on human trafficking, I am constantly being put away as a prude who doesn't want people to have sex. I'm being called a cultist member, a cultist leader, if I'm lucky sometimes. And that's just so weird to me. I'm able to talk about the chocolate industry and 2.2 million children working there. Talking about the sex industry and the wrongs of it makes me a prude. I hope I'm not, but even if I were, I brought with me some slides about what the law says about it. I mean, I'm just a campaigner. I can say anything, right? So what does the law actually say about this? Is it good? Yeah. The law is very clear on this. So it says, younger than 16, always a crime. Punishment, 2 years to 16 years jail time. Now remember, those guys got 1 day. The only people who got longer was the guy who had abused more children in that way, the guy who was a repeat offender, and the guy who was, this girl was institutionalized, she lived in a mental hospital for children, and the one guy who got more punishment was one of the youth workers working in the mental institution who helped the pimp exploit this girl. He got a couple of months. 16 to 7 years old, punishable if money has been paid, maximum of 4 years. One of the big things I've come across is people saying, well, if a boy or a girl wants to do this, I mean, they should be able to do that, right? No, it's not true. It says very clearly in the law that even if the child provoked it, engaged it first, begged for it, you're still punishable of a maximum punishment of 4 years. So, to me, it's been a world-shattering experience. I mean, I come from South Africa. I'm used to rotten things, and I never imagined to find the same things in the Netherlands. And to me, it just broke my heart. I still find it one of the weirdest things that we see, feel that our freedom is worth more than that of others. In the Netherlands, there are about 5,000 to 7,500 people who are trafficked each year. 22% of that are children, 32% of that are 18 to 20 years old. There's been a big research done by the Dutch rapporteur on human trafficking and the punishments that have been given. And one of the weirdest outcomes of that was that they could find no common factors in the length of punishment. Even weirder than that, the fact that children were exploited did not factor into the punishment. They could not see from the punishment the judges gave that the punishment was longer if children were involved. It's as if it doesn't matter that it were children that were exploited, as if children are seen the same. Well, actually, if a child has been exploited, the district attorney is supposed to give the aggravating circumstances. And it turned out in their research, they looked into 5 years of jail time sentences. They could not find it, and most of the time, the district attorneys did not ask for the legal aggravating circumstances. And to me, that's the downside of our freedom. Then some numbers about the traffickers. 25% of the traffickers were younger than 23. This is a huge problem in the Netherlands, that our young people are exploiting other young people. Maybe another shock of you, 1 out of 6 traffickers is a woman. So we women, lovely, empathetic women, people that we are also traffickers. Fortunately, in the cases of sexual exploitation, the number was lower, but still, women are a part of exploiting children. And then the other thing, sexual exploitation in the Netherlands, 33% of the traffickers were Dutch. So this is not a problem of people from other countries coming in, raping our children, exploiting our children. It's a problem of Dutch people exploiting Dutch children. And that's where it gets really uncomfortable. Because maybe some of you are sex buyers or feel that it's okay to buy sex. I've been asked for lists of, so if I follow this signal list, can I be sure that I'm not abusing someone who's being sexually exploited? There's no such list. Someone who is sexually exploited will do their utmost best not to show that to you, because their trafficker will beat them up if they don't earn enough money. There's no good answer to this. It's all about you knowing what the risks are of being a sex buyer in the Netherlands. One of the biggest pros of our legalized sex industry, that in the legal sex industry, almost no minors were found. So to me, it's an abomination if people go out in the illegal sex industry and then claim, well, how could I know that he or she wasn't 18? I mean, they look that much older. Really, they do. And I feel that it's time that we understand something about sexual crimes against children. It's much more than just a circle or a rectangle. Whether it's inside or outside of the sex industry, it's always a sex crime. And I want to end with a really beautiful quote of Baruch Spinoza. He said, "The highest activity a human being can attain is striving to understand, because to understand is to be free." I wish all of you the freedom to understand that sexual crimes are the same, whether they happen inside or outside the sex industry. Thank you.